fish in, fish out data, when they're paired together, really give us fantastic information on the status of our populations. The idea behind fish in is that we're counting and estimating the abundance of adult salmon as they enter freshwater and spawn. In terms of the research itself in the field, typically we're doing spawning surveys. So this means putting on the waders and boots, walking out on the stream where we know that salmon are spawning, and we're counting live salmon, typically counting dead salmon or carcasses, and then also looking for the nests or the reds that female salmon make when they deposit their embryos. These nests are visible to the naked eye and really effective tool for counting or estimating the total number of adults that are spawning in a given stream or river.
An adult male and female, and then two jacks on this red.
If we know the total number of nests or adult female salmon that spawn at a given habitat, then we can estimate the total egg deposition or the total number of baby salmon that would hatch from the gravel. Fish out is simply estimating the total number of juvenile or baby salmon that are heading downstream towards the ocean as they leave freshwater. These data not only tell us the abundance of those juveniles as they head downstream, but we also get great information on their life history diversity, how big they are, what time of year they're migrating, whether they're moving in big groups or individually one by one, and the types of habitats they use as they head downstream. In general, we're using these traps to catch and count the total number of baby salmon heading downstream. With the fish out information, when combined with knowledge of how many adults spawned, tells us how productive our salmon populations are in freshwater. One of the most powerful aspects of these fish in, fish out data is that they allow us to partition the life cycle. So by measuring these important transitions as adults enter freshwater, and then as the juveniles or young salmon leave freshwater, we're able to know the extent to which freshwater and the marine environment are affecting overall population abundance. It tells us how best to plan our recovery actions, so which projects to implement where, and helps us know whether or not the cumulative effects of those projects are beneficial to salmon populations. Really, it's just the overall abundance of our salmon populations, and this is just really critical information to make decisions of all sorts when it comes to salmon management and conservation.